Hi viewers, welcome to Bosco Campus Vision. I am Darshana. Hope all of you heard my previous session regarding tragedy. Today we are going to discuss about the elements of tragedy. Yesterday we concluded by saying that there are six important elements in a tragedy. According to Aristotle, the six important elements in a tragedy are plot, character, diction, thought, spectacle, song or melody. Among these six elements, plot is considered as the most important part of a tragedy. Today I am dealing with the plot. Let us discuss in detail. Plot, otherwise called mythos, is the most important part of a tragedy. Why it is called the most important part of a tragedy? It is because of so many reasons. The first reason is that the result of a man's actions determines his success or failure. I already told you, tragedy is the imitation of an action. So the result of a man's actions determines his success or failure. Hence, his happiness or misery or sorrow. And it is action which is important, not character. And character does not necessarily affect every action. Second reason is that without action, there cannot be a tragedy. But there can be a tragedy without character. And the third reason is that we all know that the other elements, that is diction, song, spectacle, thought, that are elegantly combined together to form a good tragedy. And this diction, song and thought, even elegantly combined, cannot replicate the action of life without a good plot. In short, we can say that plot is the soul of a tragedy. Character comes second, then thought, which means what a character says in a particular circumstances or situation, then followed by other pleasurable accessories, that means diction, song and spectacle. Plot is considered as the most important part of a tragedy, that is the soul of a tragedy. So Aristotle goes on to describe the elements of plot. Which are the elements of a good plot? It includes completeness, magnitude, unity, determinate structure and universality. So these, according to Aristotle, these are the important elements of a plot. The first one is completeness. So when we discuss about the definition of a tragedy, in the definition itself, Aristotle defined that it is complete and with a magnitude. So completeness refers to the necessity of a tragedy to have a proper beginning, middle and end. A tragedy should have a beginning, middle and end. Beginning in the sense means is defined as an origin by which something naturally comes to be. And end follows another incident by necessity but has nothing necessarily following it. And middle follows something just as something must follow it. So a tragedy should have a proper beginning, middle and end. And the second one is magnitude. Magnitude refers simply to length. So yesterday I mentioned that, and the preliminary discourse also, I mentioned that a tragedy should be completed within a single day. Actually that is related with the three unities. That is unity of time, place and action. Here length in the sense means unity of time. And these three unities are not formalized by Aristotle. Unity of time, place and action, these three unities were formalized by one Italian theorist named Lodovico Castelvetro in 1570. According to him, unity of action means one single plot with no loose threads. Unity of time means action takes place within a single day. And unity of place means action takes place in a single location. So, Aristotle was inspired by the theory of Lodovico, and Aristotle considered unity of action. He insists this unity of action must be strictly observed in a tragedy. And Aristotle considered this unity of time only as a general guidelines, not strictly observed in his theories. And there is no evidence to suggest that a demand for unity of place, that is unity of location. So here, magnitude in the sense means length, that is unity of time is not a strict observation here. And Aristotle defined tragedy must be of a length which can be easily embraced by the memory. That is his definition. So the tragedy must be of a length which can be easily embraced by the memory. That said, Aristotle believes that the longer a tragedy, the more beautiful it can be. But it should maintain a proper beginning, middle and end. So here unity of time in the sense Aristotle used as only as a general guidelines. It is not a strict observation like unity of action. So Aristotle suggests the action should be long enough to allow the main character to pass through a number of necessary or probable steps that take him from fortune to misfortune or vice versa. So Aristotle insists that a tragic hero or the main character or the protagonist should pass through a number of necessary steps that take him from good to bad or bad to good. That means here he termed peripeteia and anagnorisis, that is reversal of situation, that is from present state to its opposite, maybe good from good to bad or from bad to good. And next is anagnorisis, that is recognition, maybe recognition of his own identity or true nature, or recognition of other characters, their identities in the play, etc. So Aristotle insists that this unity of time is not a strict observance, and according to him, the length of a tragedy means length which can be easily embraced by the memory. And moreover, the development of the plot, that is a tragedy, its beginning, middle and end, and in the sequence of these three acts, that is the development from beginning to end, the tragedy will present a change from maybe bad fortune to good or from good fortune to bad. Next, he discusses unity. Unity refers to the centering of all the plot's action around a common theme or idea. That is a theme which unites all the action. A unified drama will have a spine, a central idea. Spine in the sense means a central idea which motivates all the action, character, thought, diction and spectacle. So unity refers to the centering of all the plot's action, include all the factors. Next point is determinate structure. Determinate structure refers to the fact that a plot joins with a sequence of causal and imitative events. So if one were to remove even one part of the plot, the entire tragedy will be disjointed and disturbed. More simply, every part of a good plot is necessary. So if the action revolves around a central spine, it creates a full skeleton of plot. But remove one bone and the entire body of action becomes unstable, since every bone radiates from the central spine and is thus fully necessary. So, every part of a good plot is necessary for the unity of a action or unity of the piece, that is tragedy. Then the last point is universality. Universality refers to the necessity of a given character to speak or act according to two laws, that is the law of probability or law of necessity. That means how all or most humans would react in a given situation. He simply states that a character must act in accordance with the human nature, either through probability, that is what most of us would do, or through necessity, that is what we are forced to do. So, according to Aristotle, a tragic hero or the main character should act in accordance with the human nature, or he should represent the whole humanity. That is the term universality refer in plot. Then Aristotle distinguishes between poetry and history, saying that history deals with what has happened. Poetry deals with what might be happened. So it presents, that poetry presents the possible as probable or necessary. So Aristotle concludes that poetry is superior to history because history always represents what has happened in the past, or it only represents fact and there is no continuity. Representation of one fact, then another fact, etc. That is, there is no continuity between different historical facts. But poetry represents universal truth or general truth, and it has a continuity. It represents both present, past and future. Then tragedy gives a feeling of necessity or at least probability to the way certain characters have given us into general principles regarding fate, choice and so on. And Aristotle concludes his session by saying that the worst kind of plot is the episodic plot, because there is no representation of that necessity or probability whatsoever between the events. So these are the main points that he discussed in the second discussion in the Poetics, or second part in the Poetics, that is the main elements of the plot: completeness, then magnitude, unity, determinate structure, universality. These are the main elements of a plot, good plot. Hope all of you understand this session. Thank you. See you again.